Hello everybody, this is Charles and I'm back with my 50th special video review, and guess what, this is for the Fewture models Geta Robo Black Geta Ryoma mode. Yeah, this is the one that I feel is most suitable to do my 50th video review for, and this is the external packaging for the box, and internally you have this that shows the internal structure of the Geta Robo. And what comes with this is the personal autograph picture by Professor Taku Robo Sato. Yep, I believe that this is a personal hand autograph thingy and not a photo print, because I've seen an online scan of a similar autograph and the strokes are slightly different. So I believe this is a personal autograph by Prof Sato himself. And without further ado, I'm gonna go to the robot himself. This is the Holy Grail Black Geta Robo. This is a very, very, very impressive piece, very heavy. I like it a lot. I didn't put in these three tabs, alright, because I'm gonna put him back in the box after this review. He's really, really nice, really, really shiny. He comes with this set of claws, like Wolverine, and it does come with an additional set of blades as well. It's really, really menacing, really, really awesome. If you like to display him in his full wing mode, all you do is take out the head, okay, and put in this cape thingy, put back his head, and on the back, what you do, you're gonna insert the cape right here. Okay, let me just find the place to put the cape in. Alright, so one thing this mode, okay, this fully armored or mode, is that it makes him very heavy. Okay, don't worry about that. I actually didn't plug in the head tightly, and by the way, yeah, this is how the head looks like. I didn't really push in the head very tightly, so it came out with the least little force. So let me just do it better. Yeah, okay, so like I said, the cape makes the body very, very heavy. It's a strain on the back, so if you wish to display him with the cape, it would be best if you actually display him with the stand that it comes with. Okay, let me just do a quick rotation on how the cape looks like at the back. Oops. Yeah, so as you can see, this cape is really, really very heavy, and I personally would not recommend that you display him without the stand, because it's really going to be a strain on the back. So this piece is really, really awesome. It's the piece that kickstarted the EX Gokin series, and it's really, really, I think, the best EX Gokin series to date. Thanks very much to Prof Sato for bringing this to us, and at this point in time, before I end our review, I'd like to pay a tribute to the late Professor Taku Robo Sato. Thank you very much for bringing this wonderful piece to us. You really brought the Chogokin level to, you really brought Chogokin to a totally new level, and I totally respect you for that. I'm sure all of us collectors respect you for that. And once again, thank you very much for this wonderful production. And here's Charles signing off with yet another Chogokin review. Catch you guys in my channel for more Chogokin reviews next time. This is how the head looks like. I didn't really push in the head very tightly, so it came out with the least little force. So let me just do it better. Yeah, okay. So like I said, the cape makes the body very, very heavy. It's a strain on the back, so if you wish to display him with the cape, it would be best if you actually display him with the stand that it comes with. Okay, let me just do a quick rotation on how the cape looks like. An impressive piece, very heavy. I like it a lot. I didn't put in these three tabs, alright, because I'm gonna put him back in the box after this review. He's really, really nice, really, really shiny. He comes with this set of claws, like Wolverine, and it does come with an additional set of blades as well. It's really, really menacing, really, really awesome. If you like to display him in his full wing mode, all you do is take out the head, okay, and put in this cape thingy, put back his head, and on the back, what you do, you're gonna insert the cape right here. Okay, let me just find a place to put the cape in. Alright, so one thing this mode, okay, this fully armored mode, is that it makes him very heavy. Okay, don't worry about that. I actually didn't plug in the head tightly. And by the way, yeah, picture by Professor Taku Robo Sato. Yep, I believe that this is a personal hand autograph thingy and not a photo print, because I've seen an online scan of a similar autograph and the strokes are slightly different. So I believe this is a personal autograph by Prof Sato himself. And without further ado, I'm gonna go to the robot himself. This is the Holy Grail, Black Gala Robo. This is a very, very, very... Hello everybody, this is Charles and I'm back with my 50th special video review. And guess what? This is for the Fewture Models Gala Robo Black Gala Ryoma mode. Yeah, this is the one that I feel is most suitable to do my 50th video review for. And this is the external packaging for the box. And internally you have this that shows the internal structure of the Gala Robo. And what comes with this is the personal autograph